Roger, TV search breakers in. And race pad clear.
Roger. And we're getting a picture on the TV.
Okay. You got a good picture, huh?
There's a great deal of contrast in it, and currently it's upside down on our monitor, but we can make out a fair amount of detail.
Okay, we can verify the position the opening I ought to have on the camera.
Stand by. Okay, Neil, we can see you coming down the ladder now.
Okay, I just checked getting back up to that first step. That hasn't collapsed too far, but it's adequate to get back up.
Roger, we copy you.
Pretty good little jump.
Buzz, this is Houston, F2, 1/160th second for shadow photography on the sequence camera.
Okay. At the foot of the ladder, the Lambert beds are only depressed in the surface about 1 or 2 inches, although the surface appears to be very fine-grained as you get close to it. It's almost like a powder. Ground mass is very fine. Yeah, I'm going to step off the lamb now. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. Yes, the surface is fine and powdery. I can pick it up loosely with my toe. It does adhere in fine layers, like powdered charcoal, to the sole and sides of my boot. I only go in a small fraction of an inch, maybe an eighth of an inch, but I can see the footprints of my boots and the treads and the fine sandy particles.
Neil, this is Houston, we're copying.
There seems to be no difficulty in moving around as we suspected. It's even perhaps easier than the simulations of 1/6G that we performed in various simulations on the ground. Absolutely no trouble to walk around. Okay, the descent engine did not leave a crater of any size. It has about 1 foot clearance on the ground. We're essentially on a very level place here. I can see